Jones of Drew's Guitar Shop in Seattle, Washington, and I wanted to show off this cool Kamaka six-string ukulele that I just got done working on. And when I say six-string ukulele, I mean six-string ukulele, not a tiny guitar, because a lot of people will call tiny guitars six-string ukuleles. But this one is actually a six-string ukulele, and what I mean by that is that it's got four strings, but two of those strings are choruses. That makes sense to you? So you've got your A that's an octave, and then you've got your C that's an octave. And so what that does is it gives you this really cool, rich sort of effect when you go in to do picking work on it especially, but it sounds really rich with chords too, so let's go ahead and play some stuff for you. It's a really great sounding uke. When it came in, it was in kind of a state. Someone had left it unhumidified in some kind of really dry environment, and so it had some cracks, and I had to stick it in a case and humidify it for a couple of weeks to get it to the point where I could actually go in and work on the cracks, which I went in and did. So those cracks have been fixed and they've been cleated, and everything is golden. There was one here, there's a couple on the top, and there's kind of one back here. But yeah, like I said, all of those have been fixed, and they've been fixed really well. I also added a bone nut to this ukulele. It had a bone nut already, but I'm really picky about stuff, and so I went ahead and replaced it anyway, because the one that was on there wasn't like a low friction one like I like carving. So I just replaced it with one of mine, and it looks better, and it tunes better, and it's I went ahead and leveled the frets, so these have been level crowned and polished. If you can see, those are real nice and shiny and smooth, and they've got a nice crown point right in the middle of the fret on each one. And I also went ahead and did a custom intonation job on the saddle. And so because this has choruses, these two strings pull slightly different tensions. Well, in some cases, pretty different tensions. And so what I go in and I do is I crown the saddle in such a way that the crown point for each string is intonated for that string. And so this has a different intonation point than this string. So what that gives you is a better octave up and down the neck, or better intonation up and down the neck, and it gives you a cleaner octave. And so that's really, really cool, because if you're somebody who noodles on your ukulele like way up here, you're gonna notice that a lot. And I bet if you're a ukulele player who noodles up there, you know exactly what I'm talking about, because intonation is oftentimes an issue with ukuleles. Even in the high end, I end up seeing ukuleles that have bridges in the wrong spot or other weird stuff going on that just prevents good intonation until some major work is done. Lastly, this is an interesting instrument because it has a pin bridge. You don't often see that on ukes. So because it has a pin bridge, I went ahead and just installed some bone bridge pins like I do on most of the acoustic guitars that I sell. And these are cool inlaid bone pins. They've been custom fit per hole, and so what that means is because they're slightly different, each one. I take the reamer and I drop it in that hole and I give it one turn, put it in, take it out, do another turn, put it in, take it out, until it's a perfect fit for each one so that you get a really nice grab, both to keep the pin in the ukulele more securely, but also to give you more contact area in the bridge so that you can get a little bit of sustain and a little bit of pop out of your trebles. So that's a pretty cool improvement, I think. So lastly, I went ahead and strung this up with a set of strings that I wanted to try. I usually love using these Aquila strings for most of the ukuleles that I sell. They just have a really nice tone. They tend to sound good on most of the instruments I put them on. And they're not expensive, so I just really love them. And I wanted to try their Lava Series stuff, and this had a six-string set, and so I went ahead and just carved the nut and everything for this set of strings, which I think sounds really cool. So I'm going to go ahead and play a little bit more on this so that you can hear what it sounds like. Yeah. This is one of the cooler sounding instruments that I've gotten in the shop. Kind of iffy actually on putting it up for sale because I've wanted a six-string ukulele for a long time. This is a really nice sounding one. I'm just not sure it's the one that's right for me. I guess I'm going to throw it up and kind of leave it up and see if somebody wants to buy it. And if somebody doesn't buy it in a while, then I might take it home. So anyway, this has been Drew Jones of Drew's Guitar Shop in Seattle, Washington. And this has been a Kamaka six-string ukulele. If you are in the Seattle area and you want to take a look at this instrument or any of the other instruments that I have for sale, or you need some repair work done, you can go to the link in the description and check out my website and give me a call. Otherwise, thanks for watching. Check out the rest of my videos and like and subscribe and all that good stuff. Thanks.